Hey, Benny Fish. It is still the 27th of February, 2018. And I've been seeing this situation at the Church of the Holy Sepulchre in Jerusalem. Right? It's been shuttered in a dispute with Israeli authorities. And, you know, being the wee young lad of a Christian that I am, my historical depth, biblically speaking, doesn't go very deep, but as soon as I started to really take a look at this, you know, it was just put upon my spirit, quite frankly, that this is not something that Jesus would very much approve of. I just don't see that as being, you know, this shrine. I mean, how do they even call this a church? With the dome and the sun symbols in it and everything like that? I don't see how Jesus would approve of all this stuff like this. You know what I mean? And I understand that, you know, going there is like a once-in-a-lifetime experience. To be able to walk in the steps of Christ and just be that close is something I absolutely long to do. But this particular building here, this church, I don't see this as a church at all. I see this as a shrine, something along the lines of a Fatima or even a Vatican. I mean, look at the garb here and all these patriarchs who are in charge of it, all from different Christian denominations. And, you know, I use air quotes when I say that because, I mean, a Christian is a follower of Christ, right? That's what it is. And when you look at the reasoning behind them closing the doors, they didn't have to. They weren't ordered to. They just decided to because they have a tax beef with the Israeli government. That's what it is. And they don't want to pay it up. These guys don't want to pay it up. And so they close the doors. And it's as if they had no regard for the thousands of people who come here for their once-in-a-lifetime journey to Jerusalem. You know, believers who think that going to this shrine, you know, will get them closer to Jesus. Maybe it does. I don't know. But it's not even where he was crucified and resurrected. That's not even the location. They say themselves it's just a traditional location. I mean, so all this thing really is, I mean, I don't know how else to look at it, but I kind of see these guys here as Pharisees and Sadducees, okay? And they are the overseers of this business, essentially. You know, they're the governing body of the Holy Sepulchre Church. However, they are under the authority of the Israel government because they're in Israel. So what would Jesus do? I think instead of turning their pilgrims away, I mean, my goodness, some of these people I think came, you know, you don't know. They brought their selfie sticks and everything, you know, they're very disappointed. So instead of closing the doors, why don't they render unto Israel what is due to Israel? I mean, it's their money, it's their country, right? Isn't that their image on the money, right? I mean, that's what Christians would do. But these guys, they don't want to do that. They don't want to do that. They believe they're standing on conviction, but it's not the right conviction in my view. You know what I'm saying? They're doing this over money. Instead of just rendering to the Israelis what's due, you know, I mean, it is what it is. If you don't like it, you know, pack up. Because this isn't even a sacred site. It's a money-making shrine. That's what it is. I'm sorry. And I do believe that some people who go there probably do get closer to Christ. So I don't take that from it. But what I do say is that is not something that Jesus would want or ever request. In fact, that's something that I think he would probably tear down, and it wouldn't take him 3 days to do it, because it's the spitting image of the Vatican, and the same thing is behind it: power, authority, and money. And that just shows right through. These guys would rather close the doors. They don't have to, but we're going to protest and keep out all these poor people who have traveled here, you know? It just blows my mind how this world is so incredibly upside down. It's really, really sad. But anyway, there it is. And that's just my take on this whole Holy Sepulchre thing. I would look at this as a good thing, as a blessing, as a gift, to allow people to truly see, you know, what is really behind all this. What is the purpose of this? Because you're not going to find Jesus in a shrine, no matter where it is. He told us himself, what is it, Matthew 24? Correct me if I'm wrong, you know. They'll tell you he's in the secret places. He's in the desert. Don't believe them, right? I mean, I'm just saying. I don't look at this as anything that Jesus would be happy with at all. You know what I mean? It's all about money. So I'm sure these men all love God. They love Jesus. But this spirit that runs through this world, man, is so cunning and so patient and so subtle and so slimy that it'll convince us of our righteous indignation and our conviction, when in reality, what's it really for, you know? I mean, seriously. So that's just something I just wanted to share with you that I saw here about this Holy Sepulchre. And they're starting to already claim that it's a Nazi-like prosecution. I mean, that's a pretty strong word, people. Usually that's thrown around by the Jews, who are constantly claiming anti-Semitism around the world, which is not untrue. But do you see the dilemma we have here? The yin-yang situation? The cannibalistic nature of the whole thing? You know? You're not going to find Jesus in a shrine. You'll find him deep, deep down in your heart. And when you do find him, don't let go. He won't let you go. But don't you go sliding back into this world, because it'll gobble you up. Okay? Has nothing to offer. Nothing. Seek Jesus Christ. Peace and grace to y'all. Many fish.
Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God,